everyone, this is Yanli Zhao. I'm a software engineer from Facebook AI. Today, I'm going to present four new APIs that have been added to PyTorch Distributed Package. First, I will introduce the two new data parallel APIs called Zero Redundancy Optimizer and FullyShardedDataParallel API. After that, I will briefly show CUDA RPC primitive support and its performance improvement. Lastly, I would like to show one example to explain the concept of sharded tensor and its future vision. First of all, let's see what PyTorch Distributed Package is. PyTorch Distributed Package is a set of features that facilitate training models in distributed systems. Usually, distributed training can be categorized into data parallel and model parallel. PyTorch Distributed Data Parallel usually trains model in each device independently for different batches of data and synchronize the results at the end of each training iteration. And the synchronization is built on top of collective calls. Model parallel usually is a process of splitting models across multiple devices and creating pipeline computation to train models across devices. It usually leads to communicate intermediate results between machines, and this communication is usually built on top of RPC or point-to-point calls. The first newly added data parallel API in PyTorch this year is called Zero Redundancy Optimizer, also called Zero. The original idea is from DeepSpeed Zero. In PyTorch Vanilla, distributed data training, data parallel training, also called DDP training, each process leads to hold parameters, gradients, and optimizer local states of the replicated model. Thus, it consumes quite a lot of memory and limited the model size that can be trained in a single device. It is observed that local state size of some commonly used optimizers could be very large. For example, island optimizer local states consumes 2 times memory than model size. Based on this observation, Zero shards optimizer states among data parallel processes to reduce memory footprint. The higher memory efficiency of Zero allows a larger scale of models to be trained in a single device. The right example shows how a training loop looks like by combining DDP with Zero Optimizer. Just like a normal DDP training loop, it first defines a model that wraps the model using DDP API. Then it defines a Zero Optimizer that wraps regular optimizer class. After that, it runs normal forward, backward pass and optimizer step. In the optimizer step, Zero will update the sharded parameters and local states, and then broadcast the updated states to peer processes, so that all the processes have the same state at the beginning of next iteration. As you can see, Zero can help training larger models in a single device, but the scale is still limited, because each process still needs to hold the whole model parameters and gradients. To further scale larger model training, fully sharded data parallel, also called FSDP API, is built up. The FSDP API is originally built by Facebook Fair Scale team. We're upstreaming the API and planning to launch it with some improvements in PyTorch 1.11. FSDP shards parameters, gradients, and optimizer states across all data parallel processes. Layers are usually wrapped with FSDP in a nested way. Wrapped layers are sharded evenly across devices. After all layers are sharded, each process will hold 1 shard of the whole model. Before first layer's forward computation, all gather is called to gather weights for that layer, and the gather weights will be freed after forward computation is done. so that the freed memory can be used for next layer's computation. In this way, peak memory is saved. Also, because of CUDA async operations, next layers altogether can be overlapped with previous layers' computation and thus can achieve good training performance. Similarly, in backward pass, weights are gathered before computation and are freed after computation. Gradients are synced after each layer's backward computation. After the whole model's backward pass is done, optimizer will update states for the local shard. Our experiments showed that up to 1 trillion dense transformer parameters can be trained on 256 GPUs using FSDP API. Also, the PyTorch FSDP API can automatically wrap layers in a nested way. So as you can see in the red example, for normal DDP training loop, users can just simply swap DDP API with FSDP API to train large-scale models in a distributed system. Above are two new data parallel APIs added in PyTorch Distributed. Next, I will briefly introduce the CUDA RPC primitive. RPC API supports point-to-point communication calls. Usually, there is a sender and a receiver. Sender usually sends a remote function call with input data. These functions with data are serialized into payloads and tensors. Once the receiver receives the message, it can deserialize the message back to function calls and data, execute the function, and send the results back to sender. During message transmission, TensorPy backend can choose the optimal communication channel to achieve best communication performance. In CUDA RPC, TensorPy can directly send tensors from local CUDA memory to remote CUDA memory. One experiment showed that there is 34x speedup compared to CPU RPC. To enable CUDA RPC, device map is required to be defined. As you can see in the red example, work 0 on CUDA 0 needs to make a remote function call on work 1 that is on CUDA 1. Then it specifies the device map from 0 to 1. With this device map, TensorPy will enable direct CUDA communication and significantly improve the performance. CUDA RPC is an important communication primitive for model parallel like pipeline parallelism. So its performance improvement can greatly improve the model parallel training. Now, lastly, I would like to show some simple example to explain the concept of sharded tensor and its future vision. Sharded tensor is an abstraction and is a single process multi-device style implementation of a tensor that is sharded across multiple devices. The vision is to enable generic intra-layer parallelism. Users just need to allocate a tensor with a sharding spec, and the sharded tensor will take care of all the distributed computations. The red example shows simplicity of intra-layer parallelism implementation for linear model using sharded tensor. First, linear layer is defined, and it specifies a sharding spec to chunk the data among four devices. The sharding spec is allocated for the weight parameter. Then the code runs as a normal linear layer. Underneath, sharded tensors are built and gather operation is called before the forward computation. Because of these sharded tensor APIs, users do not need to change their model construction codes to achieve intra-layer parallelism. Users just need to make a minimal change in the training process. So we are envisioning sharded tensor could be a generic abstraction to help users implement parallel algorithms easily in the long term. This is today's talk. Thank you for listening.